Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, so up till now what we studied the structure of basic tags and how to create a HTML document practically. That also we saw in the previous lecture. Now in this lecture or in this video we will be seeing how to create a list in the document. For an example, suppose if I want to create a list of something to be displayed on the web page, then to create those lists we have the various tags like unorder list, order list and the definition list. So in this video we will see how to make a use of all these list tags in the web document practically. Now let us see how to create a list using HTML tags. There are three types of list. Number one is called as unorder list, number two is called as order list, and number three is called as definition list. Now the difference between those lists are the unorder list are always comes with the symbols. Symbols means you can display unorder list either with the bullets, square or open circle, whereas the order list are always display with the numbers, and the definition list is used to create a definition. So let us see each list one by one. First we will start with the unorder list. To create an unorder list we use tag called as UL tag. Then every list tag contains one more tag into it, and that tag is called as LI tag. LI tag stands for the list item. So LI tag is a common in both the list, in order list also and in unorder list. So while creating a list, first we start with the UL tag, and every list item is created by using a LI tag, and after end of the everything then we close the UL tag. So let us start creating a unorder list. Now here I have created a simple unorder list where I have displayed three list items into it: physics, chemistry and maths. Now while displaying this list with the help of web browser, these list items physics, chemistry and maths, they will appear along with the bullets. Means the by default attribute or by default symbol of the UL tag is called as bullet. Now there comes a word called as attribute. So we have to understand the meaning of attribute. Tag attribute is a behavior, or you can say tag attribute is a something with the help of which we can give some special meaning to that tag. So we can change the tag's behavior with the help of those tags attribute. The tag attribute always written inside the start tag, and it has the form attribute name is equal to value. For an example, UL tag has an attribute called as type. So in the type attribute we can define three values into it. The number one value is called as circle, square or disk. The by default attribute of the UL tag is a disk, or you can call it as bullet. So if I don't mention any attribute inside the UL tag, then by default attribute, I mean the by default behavior of UL tag will be a disk. Now let us save the document and then we will see how to give or how to assign attribute to a tag. After doing this, I will click on again save. Now let us try to open this file with the help of web browser. See, this is how the list has got displayed: physics, chemistry and maths, and all these three list items has come with the bullet, or you can call them as list. If you want to change the type of this unordered list, then there are two values which we can mention specifically. The number one is called as circle and number two is called as disk. We will see both the effect of both the values. See, this is how we mention the tag attribute UL type is equal to circle. So every tag attribute is defined in this way only. Tag attribute comes with the start tag. So first we write a tag name, then we write type is equal to. I mean, for every tag there are different names of the attribute. For an example, for this tag we have the attribute name as a type. So I will write U. So I have written UL type is equal to value is circle. So this is the form of specifying the tag attribute. Attribute name is equal to value. Here my attribute name is a type and the value is circle. Now let us save the document. Now see, when I refreshed this document, I got the circle instead of the disk because I changed the behavior of the tag. So in the same way, instead of circle you can write the square also. Then instead of circle the squares will get displayed, so this is how we create a unordered list. Now in the next we will see how to create a order list. Order list basically comes with the number. So instead of the bullets in the order list, the 1, 2, 3 numbers will get displayed. You just have to change the tag name. Instead of UL, we use tag called as OL to create an order list. Save the document. Open the document with the browser. Now see, instead of circle, 1, 2, 3 has got displayed. Whenever number comes, I called it as order list. So like unordered list, in the order list, we have the by default values 1, 2, 3 numbers. If you want to change those values, then again we have the attribute called as type. Now in the type, in the order list, type attribute takes several values. You can display the capital A or small capital or small A to Z letters, or you can display capital or small Roman numbers or Arabic numbers. For an example, we will see how to display a capital letters. Again, OL type is equal to A. So when I write OL type is equal to A, instead of 1, 2, 3, A, B, C, D will get displayed. File, save. Open the file. See, instead of 1, 2, 3, this ABC has got displayed. So in the same way, you can display the capital or small Roman numbers or small alphabets. Now, one more attribute is there. That attribute is called as start. In the start attribute, suppose if I don't want to start my list with the ABC or with the numbers. Means if I want to start my list with the any random number in the list or any random numbers in the letter of character set. So in that case, I use a attribute called as start. So in the practically we will see how to use a start attribute. Instead of type, I have written here start. So when I write start is equal to D, your list won't get start with the A. It will start with the D. So start attribute is basically to start your list with any random number or with any random alphabet. So this is how we create order list. Now the next we have to see how to create definition list. Definition list is used to create a or used to display a definition. Definition list comes with three tags. Number one is DL stands for the definition list. Then inside DL, again there are two more tags, DT and DD. DT defines definition term and DD defines definition itself. For an example, suppose if I want to display the definition of operating system, then my definition of operating system will be, it is an interface between the user and computer. So here operating system is a definition term, whereas the definition it is an interface between user and computer is called as my actual definition. So how to do that we will see. I'm making a changes again. So now let us see how to create a definition list. My example is a operating system. So I will start with my definition list, always starts with the DL tag. So I will write DL. After DL, we define the definition term. My definition term is a operating system. So inside DT, I will write operating system. Now actual my definition will come. Let us save the file. See, this is how my definition list gets displayed. Operating system is a definition term, and after that I have got the actual definition of an operating system. So this is how we create a list using HTML tags. We use three HTML tags to create a list. One is your UL tag. UL tag stands for the unordered list. Then is the order list, which has the OL tag, and in the last tag is called as what, DL tag. DL tag stands for the definition list. So in the next lecture, next video, we will see more about the tags. Thanks for watching this video.